Hello again, everyone. It is the Black Knight, and this is where I shoot for a little bit quicker video here, a little perhaps more action-packed video. Like the Piper coming up? By the way, this is Piper's desk here in the General's quarters. I had to make sure she could, you know, type and stuff. But we're gonna sleep so that we can get, just take a quick nap so we get the levers in brace. She's somewhere. We don't have to worry about that. See, there was an embrace. We're gonna enter the exploration armor. Which has the jetpack and all the lead. Lead shielding. She's making a comment, and now we're going to head to the map. Let's get to the data. Where is Quarter Mastery Weathervane? Parkview Apartments. There you go.
Good afternoon. Where is Radio Freedom broadcasting across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report. Stay safe out there.
Set up a meal. Oh, heck, that's good. We could fast travel to the Parkview Apartments. This might be, you know, we may have to do another mission if this is like fast travel, place it. Some of these Mila missions, these Weathervane missions, are really annoying. There's a lot to, you have to make your way through these mazes to get to the roofs. But now I have a rocket pack, so I figure that'll help if it ever loads. Looking at the dirty bed. Any bed's a good bed if you haven't slept in a week. Okay, let's do the time warp again. Oh, here we are.
Hey, something happened.
Do you think? Something just blew up. Okay, now I don't really see. Well, maybe.
Hear that? Is that you?
All right. Let's see. I gotta go. Oh, I fell back down. And you'll have to take the stairs until we can.
Playing games with me, huh?
No.
Over here!
Hope you like them. You can't get dumb.
Are we ready to rocket jump here again?
You made a mistake! Stop. Now you pay for it!
Got the AP build.
You hit like a rad rope.
So we got raiders on one side. I think we have to get up over on that side. Can I make it to that? Let's try it. Oh yeah. That wasn't what I wanted.
Still here?
I'm being burned, so I said all. Where is that butcher? That took half his health in one shot. Come on. Poke it around. Okay. Trying to turbo boost again. And that's the whole point of this, is the whole turbo boost thing. I think I can get up there. Not quite. Man, they limited just enough. What do you think? Let's show the rocket boost power here. Let it get to 100. Okay, I got up one. I wonder if this is quicker than fighting your way through the insides. All this to place on Mila. Okay, we're going back into first person view here just so I can...
Disappear. Up.
It fell right down! Man, it's very hard to determine where you're landing. Stupid. Fine. We'll do it the old-fashioned way. Okay, so the rocket pack is kind of a sad thing here. It's just not quite enough to make things easier. And this doesn't look good. The fins. Go through. Maybe there's a way of jump packing up this way. Rackety rocket. The hit ever loads. Come up from the other side. Ah, back door. Great idea. All right, let's do this. Come on. Okay, now. We're back to this side here. But the good news, we've got stairs. Which may let us... Okay, where's this location? Probably up here. And we fell through a hole. Great. Up there? We should be able to get up to the top of that. Is it across here? There's the Mila site. Nice, Mila. Report back to Tinker Tom. And I can think we can safely say the rocket pack helped maybe a little. Oh, sorry. Sorry. Thought you were a bad guy.
What was that?
Oh, I just shot the wrong guy.
I guess we scared them off.
Yeah, I guess we shot most of them.
Certainly seen better days, haven't it?
Alrighty then, let us... excuse them. Alrighty then, let's fast travel back. Did we get all these guys here? Get all those guys. That guy still has stuff. Vacuum tubes are good. Let us fast travel. Let's see, let's go fast travel to home plate. Dump this stuff off. No, I don't want the workshop, sorry, it's the wrong button. Yeah, let's see, inventory, my weapons, we don't need a board, or that, or this, or that, or the other thing, and this, and that. No, we don't need those. Okay, those we want for the other place, that for the other place, I guess we'll leave that. We don't need this stuff here. Some point we'll unload all this for huge gobs of cash. But the main thing... is have a nap. Can't take a nap in power. We're fine. Come on. Transform. Need a 1 hour nap. Or even an 8 hour nap. There we go. Why? Because now, before we go cash in the Mila and get the XP, we'll get the bonus from the lover's embrace.
Lovely night.
And we'll power up. In case we go right into another Mila. Fast travel. Where is? We know it's right around there. It is. Doot doot doot. Where is the darn? In the heart of everything. It's got its own unique little thing. There it is. Railroad HQ. The little lantern thingy. The thingy of lanterns. Let's do the time warp again. Armored guy coming on in. Let's see, where is Dipty?
You need the dendrites. Randolph's got a message for you.
Thanks, drummer boy. The safe house deal, okay.
Make sure you're never followed here. It's all our asses if you are.
Are you injured?
Everyone's all, you've been hitting the Kims way too hard. But I got my eyes open. I see.
The world's a dangerous place.
Hey,
for anyone
you
in
keep
my
placing
life.
Milas, and I'll keep paying you. I know another building that could use a Mila.
All right, we're not done. Okay.
If you need something for the road, the shop's open.
Anything new from Mila?
Ooh, Pam's like a glowing one in a crater, soaking up all the data from Mila's cameras. The atmospheric sensors haven't picked up anything yet, but give it time.
I gotta go.
Right you are.
Okay, we should be able to beam right out of here. Next to Fanuli Hall. We're beaming in. Fast traveling like fast people. You just imagine just walking for hours. It's really probably what, you know, the whole thing ends up being. But not as long as it takes to load. Let's do the time warp again. All right.
This is now a combat zone. You may suffer harm up to and including death.
Okay, this is we're in the middle of something bad here. There we go.
If we're gonna dance.
Okay, where am I supposed to be going here? Indoors seems like a better idea. We're trapped between the super mutants and raiders again.
One more obituary.
Piper, you set off a suicider. She's so resilient. Hey, I needed nuclear material. That was very good. Lots of bits of them here.
Back it in, boys. Up to that
wizard. Something's running up on me.
Did you hear that?
Where are we supposed to be going? Hold on. Inside that, up on top of that building. Trying to see if we can do this. If we can do the Spider-Man. Come on.
Bucket heads! Die!
Go ahead and hide, little
Okay. This is kind of working. Need to recharge it again.
I wanted a fight!
Let's go up here. Tells me I've left Piper to a, well, what would normally be a horrible death.
What the?
Someone there? All the
future! Alright, let's do another boost.
Real bad move.
Where'd you go?
It's all the way up there,
gonna
isn't it?
Find you! Gonna kill you!
How'd she get up here? Sure awesomeness, I guess.
Certainly seen better days,
you're
hasn't
here.
It?
You're here! Stop hiding!
Wanted a fight!
Okay.
I hear something!
Let's see. All right. I think we're close here. Can we make it to that gap? Okay, is there a way in through here? You drop in through there? I don't think I can jump any further. No, this is just decorative. And yet, they have stuff there that you're supposed to be able to find. Okay. You know, I'm even going to put away the gun here for a minute so I can see a little better. This is going to be more Spider-Man stuff. Okay. We'll try to go for that ledge next. I kind of leave Piper to kill the super mutants. Not very romantic of me, I admit. Okay, we back up here, we recharge. I'm not sure this is easier than just going through the building. Okay. Can we get all the way up there? In one turbo boost. I mean, we can survive the fall. We're in power armor. There we go. Come on, up, 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 up. No, it's the, wait, what's here? We are up pretty high. Right, that we're on the roof. I'm gonna try and boost over this wall. And okay, we may have to walk around it. It. Man, it's like there's a wall there. Just to prevent you from doing what I'm trying to do. Alright. We did it. Mila placed! And you're just amazing. You're out there killing all those super mutants in the soaking rain. I'm just jumping around like an idiot. Red X, get some stuff, get some more stuff, get all this stuff. And let's see. Fast travel back to the Railroad HQ. Setting up Mila's in record time.
We got a lot of synths in play right now. Makes things really dangerous.
I'm getting tired of waiting.
Establishing Mercer's safe house is a sign we're on the road to recovery. Thank
you. Andrew's a goofy guy.
Hey.
You must not be afraid of heights with all the work on the Mila project. You got the time? I got another site we could place another one of my babies.
Where now?
If you need something for the road, the shop's open.
I gotta go.
Right you are.
Hey, where's where we started?
Things are quiet. For now.
The Boston Bugle. Near the corner. Okay, we don't have the Boston Bugle itself on the map, so we'll go to, let's see. This is not a friendly area. Old Corner Bookstore, which I know is hostile. You know it's bad when you start out and there's just a dead guy. Now, which way are we going? Which way are we going? Let's hardly ride up Piper's Alley, headed for the Boston Bugle.
Wish it hadn't come to that.
That was pretty quick, though. Do we take their stuff? Of course we take their stuff. Of course we take their stuff.
I guess they're not interested in sharing, huh?
Boston Bugle, Boston Bugle. You know, y'all know where the Boston Bugle is. Alright, this one we ought to be able to do. Oh dear, no we're not. Up there. Okay, never mind. Keep it down. We're gonna have to close. Sorry, I didn't know you were right there about the last of people. We're gonna have to shoot our way through this one, because that there's no ledges. I mean, I can't jump that high. We're gonna have to go in here and find an elevator, hopefully. Yep, an elevator. That's what we're hoping for. Blown out. Is that blown out? Yeah, it looks blown out. Somebody was at his post today. Everything ended. Eyeglasses, the Boston Bugle. The Boston Bugle. We got so many of the Boston Bugle. The Boston Bugle. Okay, let's hit the call button here. Hop on in.
Going up.
Up was the goal. Hopefully to the roof. That's not far enough.
You stay for the combat inhibitor and watch the fireworks.
Well, I just killed him. Is that okay? At least we're getting some guidance here. Typewriter for the baby. We love our typewriters. Oh, we've got a system here to get into. Bill. Sick.
Nice.
Nine Bill sick. There you go. Case closed on crime boss Eddie Winter. Yeah, you bet it is. Remove the shocked and angered people of Massachusetts. The Boston Police Department announced last night they've ceased all investigations into the actions of the reputed organized crime boss, Edward Eddie Winter. Speaking on behalf of the special task force that had been assembled specifically to build the case against Winter, Captain Jonathan Widmark of the BPD said, after reviewing the evidence with our colleagues at the Bureau of Alcohol, Drugs, Tobacco, Firearms, and Lasers, I like it, if you ain't clear that we were in fact wrong. Eddie Winch has indeed been a colorful history, but it's not a criminal history. By pursuing our case against Mr. Winter, we would simply continue to waste taxpayer dollars and, even worse, condemn an innocent man. It was an unexpected turn of events, to be sure. According to Boston Bugle's confidential sources within the Boston Police Department, the innocent man was anything but. As uncovered by Captain Widmark's official investigation, codenamed Operation Winter's End, Eddie Winter was involved in pretty much every crime imaginable, from petty larceny to first-degree murder. And although nothing was proved, everybody on Widmark's task force suspected Winter in the August homicide death of their lead detective's fiancée, a Miss Janitor Lands. And that, of course, was the detective whose memories were eventually given to our good friend Nick. Article 2. The China Showdown, the Atomic Ultimatum. Well, this could be interesting. War. Has there ever been any extended period of time in history's recent memory in which soldiers have not fought, bled, and died, all for the sake of furthering the political goals of one government or another? The shorter answer is no. That's even true now. The longer, more terrifying answer is that we have not yet begun to experience the extent of human suffering. From Anchorage to frigid Alaska to Shantou or our enemy's doorstep, enemy American troops have been embroiled in a brutal battle. They have taken and lost many lives. A nearly uncountable number, but not entirely, because the truth is the casualties have been countable. These conflicts, however horrible, have all been, in some inexplicable, perverted way, manageable. Through taxes and various wartime revenues, the United States government has been able to fund a standing army, the likes of which this country had never before seen, which would be really impressive. Excuse me. The same is certainly true of our mortal foe, China. And with each dollar, I have to do this, China! And with each dollar spent comes a natural, I don't know why I had to do that, I just had to. Anyway, of how that dollar was spent. Every bullet, every bunker-busting bomb, every body bag. Soon after each is used in the theater of war, we know every how, when, and where. But the sad, obvious truth is that the days of manageable war have nearly come to an end. In the minds of world's great leaders, those billions of dollars haven't merely been spent, they've been wasted. Because here we are, after more than a decade of constant warfare with no clear end and no clear winner in sight. So really, at this point, what other option do these superpowers have, if not the nuclear one? And therein, of course, lies the rub. For when China or the United States launches these nuclear missiles and drops its atomic bombs, there will be no one left to count the casualties, let alone the ordnance. No one left to declare victory. So, then only one question remains. Is there any way the powers of the world can prevent a nuclear apocalypse? Is there any hope left for the world? We must believe the answer is yes. But these are hopeless times. And yeah, more hope in the video game. They're completely hopeless times. Let's hope we're not following that track. Jeeper, I'm just depressed. Oh, it's Article 5. No, we don't go in order. No, we want to go. I said go in order. Article 3. The Boston food riots continue. Can only be described as a scene of absolute pandemonium. On Friday afternoon, soldiers of the United States Army's 184th Infantry Regiment opened fire on a group of armed civilians after an unknown person smashed the plate glass window of the Roxbury Food Bank, prompting several people in line outside to storming into the establishment. As of yesterday evening, at least four people were confirmed dead and eight others injured, but Jonathan Corman, spokesman for the Army, says the truce acted within their authority. If owners in question ensured explicit verbal warning several times, those people knew exactly what would happen if they broke the line and attacked the food bank. Hunger is no excuse for civil disobedience, vandalism, or in this case, starting a riot that puts the lives of every civilian in the area at risk. It is the sole role of the United States Army to maintain order in this difficult time, and that is exactly what happened in this instance. I would also like to point out that the soldiers of the 184th Infantry Regiment have not had a food ration in 2 days. These men and women understand hunger probably better than anyone. It is a response the American people have grown accustomed to, as violent scenes like that in Roxbury have played out again and again across the country as a starving populace tries desperately to obtain food for its families, and as happened so many times in the past, a civilian witness of the so-called riot tell a different tale. 85-year-old grandmother Hannah Henry was in line at the food bank and claimed the soldiers had anything but order and liberty on their minds.
They were laughing, joking about who they were going to shoot first. It's not a game to them. The soldiers may not have fired on the crowd before the window got broke, but they was looking forward to it all the same.
One can only hope that the violence in Roxbury will be the last such incident our country has to suffer through, but until America finds the strength to question its domestic policies and the food to feed its people, the future remains uncertain. And it's... That was very shortly before... This is all very shortly before the end in the game here. White House remains empty. Where is our president? Now that's interesting. You've never heard this part. For more than half a year, the West Wing of America's most famous residence has remained shrouded in near complete darkness. A skeleton crew of manual laborers remain on staff to maintain the property, but no one has lived or worked politically there for several months. And even though the White House press corps was officially and unceremoniously disbanded around the same time, the media has remained steadfast in answering the most important questions. Where is our president? At first, the assumption was that the entirety of the United States operation had moved operations to Raven Rock. Oh, Raven Rock. Well, we know about Raven Rock. The military... Well, if you don't know about Raven Rock, play Fallout 3. Especially the add-on there. The DLC is what I'm looking to try to say. The military operations center, located in the mountainous region of Pennsylvania, just a few miles northeast of the presidential retreat in Camp David, Maryland. But further investigations have revealed that neither the president nor his cabinet have been to the Raven Rock complex in over a year. So if not Raven Rock, then where? Thanks to extensive and exhaustive investigation, the Boston Bugle has uncovered the answer, and our readers will likely consider it as strange as it is shocking. The president has been leading our country from a Poseidon Energy oil rig. Ooh! The oil rig! That's from Fallout 1. Well, 1 and 2, I believe, just off the coast of San Francisco. It's certainly an odd choice for a presidential command center, or is it? Not as much as it may seem, for as our investigation discovered, thanks to the testimony of the highly placed anonymous source, the Boston Bugle has learned that the official designation of the oil rig is actually Control Station Enclave. So wait a minute, now they're saying... excuse me. What this is saying is that the Enclave existed before the war. That is a very big deal. Giving credence to the long-standing rumors of a secret militarized shadow government known as the Enclave that would take control of the United States in the event of a nuclear conflagration. So the Enclave... See, now... I always thought that the Enclave kind of gelled after the war. This is saying that the Enclave happened before the war and may have even started the war, or at least, you know, we know the canon, I think, says China shot first. But, and so the mystery of the missing president has finally been solved, but in doing so, has the Boston Bugle also uncovered evidence that the end of the world in the form of total atomic war is also at hand. Sadly, the president's silence also seems to speak volumes. Now, are they saying that now, because they were expecting it, that's when they've activated the shadow presidency? All right, this is really getting my attention here now. Article 5. Boston head for the first World Series win since 1918. Wow, now, you can truly see that this is a parallel universe thing, or this is just a joke that they threw in there before, Boston broke the curse. Every resident of Boston is faithfully aware it's been 159 years since the city. This almost happened, folks, but, you know, thank goodness the Sox were able to pull some stuff out in the meantime. Not much sooner than 159 years, but still. Jesus has reveled in the joy of a World Series victory. Whether from strikeout error in the outfield or a ball that rolled disastrously through an infielder's legs. Okay, that's funny. They really, really, that happened, of course, in our timeline. Defeat has remained our constant, unwelcome companion, but not for long. It has been one of the most exciting World Series races that Boston has achieved a 3-0 lead over the unbeatable Texas favorite. Batting, fielding, and pitching have all aligned, and thanks largely to the direction of the legendary coach Dusty Wilder, giving this year's team the best chance we've had for victory in, well, forever. Even more encouraging that Game 4 being played here in Boston is the fact that the team has yet to utilize their star pitcher, Matt the Missile Murdock. With him on the mound, they are actually predicting not only a series-shattering win. Some are actually predicting not only a series-shattering win, but a no-hitter to boot. Yes, for years, the concession stands of Boston have fed baseball fans a steady diet of beer, hot dogs, peanuts, and bitter defeat. But on Saturday, October 23rd, 2077, the only thing that could snatch away the victory is an act of God or some obscene calamity of man, like a nuclear war. Tomorrow, my friends, the unthinkable will finally come to pass, and life in Boston will never be the same again. Oh, that's sick. So, in this time, in this world, Boston never wins the World Series again because during the game or just before the game, the world ends, basically, as the nuclear war happens. And that was worth the trip. This whole thing that worth it to the video, because I'll tell you what. I'm happy with that. That's great. To grab some typewriters, because my baby loves typewriters. Maybe loves typewriters and cigarettes. I actually don't think Piper smokes. Does she smoke? I don't know. Beacon Hill open. Are we on the top floor? That didn't seem like a long enough ride. Yes! Look at this! No, this isn't up far enough. This is not good. No! That's the Mila point! Alright! Play some Mila. We gotta play some Mila. And we go back to Tom. He's just gonna give us another Mila. Whiskey and... I hear a helicopter. You hear a helicopter? And those Brotherhood guys are blasting the crap out of somebody. The brothers. Well, while we still can't... Wait, there you go. They're coming over this way. I didn't call in for anybody. You guys are good. There should be a super mutant enclave around there someplace. So they're just doing something with that, probably. It sounds like there's people hammering on something, but that's actually, you know, gunfire. Oh, look at that. Oh, Raiders. Oh my goodness, they crashed. I'm sniping. Okay, let's do the alt hold breath.
They left. Blue, we're not alone here.
If it hits him,
that was?
I'm looking at the bad guy in the scope.
Something's out there.
Not for long. That was for those guys there. And before anything else weird or bad happens, I think it's time to head back to base. What do you think? The castle. Yes, I could go get another Mila. Maybe that's the 11th Mila, I don't know. I don't have a feeling that we're at 11 yet. We don't want to make this a Mila marathon any more than it already is. So let us get back to someplace safe, someplace warm and cozy to close out the video. And next time we'll take up some more Milas, maybe do that drop, that dead drop dealio. But for the right now, break it on down, pull the fusion core.
Learn history lest it repeat itself.
Keep
Everything
going on.
Seems to be proceeding according to plan, sir.
Don't much care for good neighbor. That place is nothing but trouble.
I think, you know what? Yeah, let's see something here. Can you see? That's Spectacle Island, definitely, because that's where I pick up my stuff. But you can't see the giant things they've built over there. That's always annoying. Still. I think it'd be good just to sit here and out on the veranda. You can come over when she feels like it. You gotta walk off these missions sometimes. On this note, ladies and gentlemen, this is your Black Knight looking out at Spectacle Island from the castle. Have a great night.